fancy carrying your water bottles with your eyelids or using an electric drill to clean your nose? Guizhou is home to the most versatile stuntmen on the planet. We just had to meet this daredevil and we're completely shocked by what he showed us. But just see for yourselves.
因为我这个人天生非常好奇，我看到别人做了很多危险的事情，我都想去尝试一下。
比如说人家表演的绝活是一个一个的表演，我就把五个我就自己组合起来，把五个绝技融为一体，就增加了好多难度，很多人都做不到的。He told us that it takes a long time to learn a trick. Especially before he felt comfortable doing the stunt that got him into the Guinness World Record book. Carrying 20 kilograms of water with hooks in his eyelids.
I was young, my father搞那个民间的 一些活动啊，一些祭祀活动啊，有这种类似的表演，那个表演呢，难度不是很高，比如说上刀山下火海，比如踩刀啊，踩火之类的。然后我就通过这些，看过这从小就受过这样的影响，然后我就去练，就去模仿。练好了以后呢，我就觉得这个难度不是很高，因为这个都是我们少数民族很多人都会的，所以我就想呢。
That's why he comes up with more and more ideas for new tricks and combinations of the most difficult ones.
Okay. 我现在做一个就是我们少数民族的上刀梯，上刀梯呢就是我那个有个刀架在脖子上拉车。 一把刀架在脖子上拉汽车，但是我的脚下还有两把长长的刀，然后我就脚踩在刀上，然后同时拉车，然后车上也站上很多，就是比如说吹拉弹唱的乐队在上面表演。
Barely a mark, and he didn't even have a master to teach him.
比如说我的吞铁蛋子啊，吞铁蛋的时候，我看到别人在表演的时候，别人一般不教人的，都是他们都是有老师传授的，因为我家里穷，我也交不起学费。 所以当时我第一次试验的吞铁蛋的时候，怎么吞铁蛋呢？我就用一个乒乓球，穿上一个线，然后呢，使劲的把它吞下去。我就怕万一吞下去吐不出来，我可以拉那个线子，它就能够出来。这样反复好多次都很难受，有的时候吐不出来，有的时候吐出来。吞下去以后，会把里面的吃去的饭都一起会吐出来的，所以呢，难度很难受。 这就是慢慢的长时间练的就练出来了。这个是这样的，如果一个正常的人通过训练以后，但看他的这个人的承受能力，他的有没有这个天赋，但是十个人当中可能只选出几个人，不会说所有的人都敢，有些人的胆子特别小。
Really, it was inevitable that Jess would have to try as well. Since she conveniently faked flu, the electric drill fell through. But as it turns out, even the simplest rope trick looks easier than it actually is. So she resolved to the only thing left, pulling.